We want to spread this around to as many of our experts as we can. And joining us now on the phone, we have David Bahnsen. David, obvious question. We've got a rate cut from the Fed and possibly rate cuts elsewhere and possibly some easing by the Federal Reserve. That is pumping money into the economy. Will that help the market? Will it help the economy?
It will not help the economy. It may very well help the market in a repricing sense. It boosts the equity risk premium, as if a 1.5% Fed funds rate was not already helping equity valuations enough. There already is some global coordination. You saw yesterday Japan's bank, central bank, bought 400 billion yen of their government bonds and pledged to do more. I do agree with your prior guest that that's what you'll see more of now, effectively a quantitative easing. But, Stuart, it's not that I'm down on the decision. I just want to be very clear as to why they're doing it. They're doing it to give a psychological boost to financial markets. It doesn't do anything to the real economy.
David Bahnsen, I'm not so sure that 0% interest rates, if we do get there, is a good thing for anybody.
It's a horrible thing. It, first of all, signals a level of panic that was like what we had at the financial crisis, quite literally, which is just astronomically absurd compared to the real economic gravity of this. But also, Stuart, you made the point earlier about the president's feeling that, oh, we need to get our dollar lower because other currencies are doing it. Well, all we're doing is facilitating a race to the bottom. Not everybody can indeed just keep going lower and lower without tremendous economic damage. And as the prior guest also said, hurting our own banks and financial institutions. It's a negative feedback loop. I think that the Fed has done what they need to do here, but the reality is that if they go much further, and as you said, get to a zero interest rate, which is where I think they will end up going eventually, they've just left themselves without bullets for a real sustainable economic downturn. That's something that we should be very scared about.
Okay. David Bahnsen still with us. You wrote the book on Elizabeth Warren and almost single-handedly got her out of the race, I might add. She's still in it, but she's fading fast. Do you think that politics has anything to do with the market today, Super Tuesday?
There's a sort of correlation with how the market's selling off because of coronavirus and all that panic of last week, not related to Bernie, then creates the risk that Trump's economic calling card is not as strong as we need it to be. And then, therefore, you get a knock-on effect of, wow, what if you do get Bernie or somebody else? So there's sort of this connection from the dominoes, you know, one sort of begets the other. And that's the concern, I think, that markets have. I don't totally agree with the other guest that Biden is the same level of risk as Bernie. I think that any scenario where you end up with a candidate versus Trump, who that candidate is not Bernie Sanders or Elizabeth Warren, is better for markets. On the margin, of course, I'm not a Joe Biden supporter either, but I do think that Bernie is the real tail risk for markets.
David Bahnsen, to you now. Mike Bloomberg, a presidency, would that hurt the market?
No, Bloomberg would not hurt the market, and Bloomberg is never, ever, ever going to be your president.
Oh, that's true. Okay.
Yeah, you never know.
Yeah, you said that before 2016. At least a lot
that's
of people
true.
Would say Trump could never be the president, and he is the president. Yep. That's the truth. Got it.